Okay, good morning, family. So this is my fourth bedroom, and it's actually gonna be my closet. Well, let me put my fingers up there. Let me let it focus. Okay, so this bedroom is actually gonna be my closet, but before it becomes my closet, it used to be my puppy's room because we didn't have anywhere for them to go. And you know, puppies sometimes like to get in stuff, so this is what they got into. They actually put a hole in the wall. So we're gonna repair that today. Hang out with me. All right, y'all, so you see, when I took my paper and I marked on the wall how big my hole was, what I did was I just laid it down on top of my new drywall and I skewered it so that I would have the same. Thing here, so I can move this off of that. Now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna crack this a little bit because we're gonna keep a lot of the paper on the outside. That way this piece should fit directly into that hole, and then I can use those boards there and on the other side to drill it into. Also, it's gonna leave the paper flat all around these sides here, which will cover that up, which is what I'm going to be taping, and I'm also going to be plastering. So stay with me. So I'm just cutting on my lines and I'm using my box cutter. Sorry y'all, my camera is, I'm waiting on my new selfie stick to come and my stands are not real crazy. So I'm kind of working with my iPad and my phone right now. So sorry that you can't see this part that I'm doing. But if you can see, you see I already have this line on the board. So I'm just gonna use my box cutter and go in so I can actually cut this piece out that will go in that hole. And then I'm gonna have these on the outside to kind of hang. You'll see what I mean. And I'm using my ruler because that's what I used the first time. Tell you what, this ain't as easy as I thought it was gonna be. I thought it was gonna be kind of, oh, this will be simple, I can do this and now it's not. So people, just know that it's worth it though. I can't wait to see it all finished and know that I did it. So this is the first thing that I'm doing in my house, is getting this room together for this closet. The next thing is, these floors gotta come out. I'm gonna change the floors in here for the closet. I don't know what I'm gonna change it to yet, but it's gonna be changed. So let's see. It looks so easy. But this don't look as easy as they say. I'm about to get me a knee pillow, y'all. I see that now. I'm about to invest in another knee pillow. I used to have one, which was the seat for my son next to my track. You know how you have those little seats? I bought it. It had the school logo and all that stuff on it. But, I don't know what happened to that. That used to be my knee saver. So now I'm just going through the drywall, because you know the drywall is thick. So I'm just going through so that I can get this piece out. Mm-hmm.
So what I'm realizing is that the drywall they had on the tutorial that I saw is not the same drywall as this one. But it's okay. We're gonna still do the same thing. So this is how it's looking so far. Now, this, I'm realizing, this actually gonna be outside. I'm trying something different. I'm gonna make it wider on the edges, like the outside where the stud is, and then I'll just have to remove the drywall on top of the stud. That way I just put it right into the stud. Like drill into the stud, tape it, go ahead and get the spackle on it and be done. That's what I'm gonna do. So I'm adding 2 inches on both sides. One thing I know is I'm gonna make mistakes while I'm making improvements to my home, but I'm okay with that. Because I'm gonna learn from these mistakes. So I'm okay with it. But we're gonna fix this wall today. This is where I added the 2 inches on this side. And this was good because I hadn't went deep in that yet. So these are going to be, and then I'm going to take that and paint it a little bit. But this is what I'm adding so that I can put this over top of the studs that are already in there. And then I can just drill this into the stud before I plaster it up and caulk it up. So we're still in good shape, y'all.
All right, y'all, so y'all can see I got the drywall piece in there. And what I did, and these are the extra 2 inches I did so it can be on the wood. See the wood right there? So I'm actually going to screw those in so this stays nice and stationary. Like right now, it's not going anywhere. Like it's stuck in there, but just to make sure. So I'm going to add a couple screws on both sides. And then we can start taping. But I, listen, y'all, for my first house DIY project, I'm feeling real good about this because, boom, listen, the hole is really gone now. So now, and make her look good. Next, it's going to be, I actually have a new door coming soon. This door is going to be gone because I'm going to put a glass door up here because this, again, is my closet. So I want the glass door right here. And then I'm also getting a new door jam. So let me just tell y'all, when you have big puppies, even when they have stuff to do in a lot of room, I mean, trust me, it was toys and everything. Sometimes they just want something to gnaw on. And my puppies decided to gnaw on my door jams. But it's all good. We're going to have that fixed. So y'all see the before with the room before it becomes my huge closet. Because remember, this right here is going to be a hole in the wall. This is where this is where it's going to open up to the other closet on the other side. So let me get busy on putting these screws in here and then we. So here is the tape that I'm using, and this is the brand I'm using, FibaTape. It's in too far, so I'm about to pull it back out because when I was doing it, I did it too tight. Let me just say, I think this is a better problem to have than it doesn't fit. So, here we go. It's in there. And it's nice and tips. And it's nice and tips. Alright, y'all, so the wall is taped on. I got the tape on there. So the next thing I need to do is I'm gonna go get the broom. so I can clean the mess on the floor, because the next thing I'm gonna do is start caulking my I came here, y'all, because I used to have a broom that I kept in here, but I think I took it downstairs. So go get the broom, we'll get stuff cleaned up. And so the next thing we're gonna do is we're gonna put the caulk on there, and I have two kinds. So this is the first excuse me. This is the first one I'm using. All purpose G-Rock. Excuse me. Okay, yeah, so this is the first one I'm using. I'm gonna use put this on there to get it nice on the wall, coat it real good, sand it, have to come back and do that one again, do it again. And then I also have this one. And the reason I have this one is because I wanna do this at the very end before I sand it. Because when this dries, it dries white. So it comes on pink and it dries white. So I got this to make sure it's good and dry before I try to do anything to it. So I'm gonna use the first one. Then I'm gonna put this one on top so that I know that it's dry. Stay with me. Let me go get a little clean up done first. Alright, now, so I had to save a little money. So I'm gonna put this first coat on top of this tape, and I'll be back. Alright, y'all, so this is what it's looking like right now. And I'm really impressed, y'all. I'm excited. I cleaned the hole. So let me finish spackling and sanding and all that good stuff. And because you gotta let this sit and then sand it and come back and do another coat. So I'll see y'all in a little bit. Alright, so again, that's done. It's nice and smooth. Let me get my fan going. So I got a fan right here. This is gonna help it get dry. I'm gonna put the fan right there. And I am gonna clean up this mess, y'all. I'm gonna really clean up the mess for real. This time, let's get this done. But I figured, why clean up too much mess? Because it's gonna get dirty again. Alright, so fan. Now it's on. That way that can dry. And I'll be back to sand it and put another coat. Progress, y'all. Look at that. She is smooth. Yo, she's smoothing out. Thank you. What's up, y'all? It's your girl, Kay Stu, and I am here to show you the final results. Y'all, I'm so excited. It's gone. The hole is gone. It is smooth. I sanded it out. Now I can paint it. So the crazy part is there's going to probably be a shelf or something right there in front of that little part. But still, you want to fix the wall anyway. So my first DIY, I think, was successful. This is part one. Stay with me as we start this closet together. So the next thing is, and I'm not going to be doing that, I'm going to probably get a contractor, is to come and get the opening here for the closet. Be one huge, massive closet. And then the last thing will be putting the new door and the new door jam in. So I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Yeah, that's it. I just came out here to finish the video because I didn't like the echo inside the bedroom. But I learned a lot on this project. One thing I learned is you got to make sure you have the proper tools. Now, I have a lot of tools and stuff because I've always DIY construction. That's just been my thing. I always did like little stuff or building stuff or, you know, repurposing things like that. So, but to actually go in and fix my wall in my house, that was huge for me, y'all. That was huge. And again, you got to have the proper tools. Like when I went in there, I just thought my box cutter was going to be enough. It wasn't enough. I had to go get my little handsaw that I had to cut the drywall. Again, with the tape and the plaster, you want to make sure you just have everything that you need so you don't have to stop and pause. Even the sanding, I thought I was just going to end up sanding with my hand. But I used my electric sander and it went faster and it came out way smoother than I probably could have did with my hand. So I'm excited and I'm looking forward to many more DIY projects so that I can create the home. Like, I bought this home because the bones are great. Like, it's a brand new home. I had it built from the ground up. And there's so many great things I love about this home. But there's a few things I want to change. And building that big closet is my first thing that I want to change. So this is part one. Stay with me. The next thing I'm going to be doing is, again, opening up the space. Now, I'm going to get a contractor to come out here and let me know if that is a load-bearing wall. Because if it's a load-bearing wall, then you have to do some different adjustments and I probably won't end up getting my closet like I want. But I don't think it's a load-bearing wall. But I'm going to double check because I don't want no issues. I don't need my roof sinking in or no crap like that. So I'm gonna double check, but I'm pretty sure it's not a load bearing wall, and that way I can go ahead and start getting the entrance done. I'm actually gonna put an arch up there as well, and I am going to be doing these things myself. Like I said, I'm gonna have someone come help me, but I am basically gonna be doing everything myself. I've been watching a lot of DIYers and tell you, I've just been inspired. Like, I think to myself sometimes, like, what are you waiting for? Just get up and do it. Like, it's your house. If you mess it up, you just got to fix it. But not doing anything at all is even worse. So I made a point to myself to say to myself that I'm not waiting anymore. I'm going to do and get the things and create the life that I want to have. And I look forward to you all sharing that with me and going through the journey with me and seeing what's going on with my house. So again, the first part of the closet was fixing the wall. Peace out. I'm gonna die.